Corporation, and it's one of our Share Life activities. We're raising money for the causes. I'd like to introduce to you the conductor of our junior band, Mrs. Irina Tomchik.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm honored to be able to present to you the youngest group of all the ensembles in our school, the junior band. The band consists of music students from grade 9 and 10, so please give them a warm welcome and enjoy the evening.
March Militaire, composed by Franz Schubert and arranged by John Kenyon. We would like to welcome the grade 9 students to the music department, and we hope that they will continue to take music and join senior ensembles. Some of these students have only been playing for a couple of months. Great work, guys. I would like to introduce the next piece, the Harrogate Festival, composed by John Edmondson.
Thank you.
Part of our celebration tonight is to present some awards to students. The first awards that we're going to give tonight are to two students who are finishing the grade 10 program, who have been involved in music since arriving in high school, and have demonstrated that they are becoming very good musicians and enthusiastic people who will do a lot of wonderful things in the senior division. Mrs. Tomczyk, would you like to come up and make the presentations, please? Music teachers, we all hide in the back room when we're not performing. Two award winners this year. The first winner, going on to the senior division, Holly Rowan. And the other winner of the Junior Music Award this year is Jason Caron. Next act we'd like to present to you are members of our grade 11 guitar class. And if they would come in now, they'll introduce the program to you. Grade 11 guitar class.
Micah Dante will perform a classical Spanish solo written by Steve Howe of the rock group Yes. This piece is entitled Mood for a Day.
Your next performance is by the Grade 11 guitar class with Micah Dante, Ken Piper, Brian McKinnon, Phil Svensson, Jason Tobin, Andrew Zalmita, Richard Nolk, and myself, Davo Philipse. The song we're playing is called Patience and is written by Axl Rose.
mascot that has their lights on. The license plate number is PVM623. That's a car in the parking lot that has their lights on. It's PVM623.
Thank you. Okay. That song was Good News by Sammy Nestico. The next song is a very popular song. It was a theme song from the 1988 Winter Olympic Games. It's called Can't You Feel It, written by David Foster and arranged by Paul Lavender. This song features Geraldine Espejo on the alto saxophone.
Ladies and gentlemen, these are the Leger Singers, our senior choir school here. In addition to concerts we do in schools throughout our community, we also sing in churches. And as a matter of fact, we're singing the Mass at St. Mary's at 12:30, and we've also been invited to sing High Mass at St. Patrick's in Quebec City during our tour. We would like to sing for you a piece that we will be using in our church services called For the Beauty of the Earth. Mrs. Tomchick and Janice Zeal on flute, and our accompanist. We do keep our parish priest busy. He's our accompanist, Father Kerfoot. fear that the Leger singers will be involving themselves directly in a festival that is ranked. And in Quebec, we'll be doing one of the necessary numbers is Canadian folk material. I'm going to sing a Nova Scotia folk song for you right now.
Thank you.
to be with them again. Our baritone soloist, Wayne Tan. Occasionally, these festivals you go to, I feel they get a little bit stuffy. There are all kinds of rules, regulations. They think that we give you rules and regulations at school. When you go to a festival, they mark you on how you sit, you can imagine. Along with all these rules and regulations, there are some very definite pieces, types of pieces you must play, and I always like to throw in a lighter number at the end of our participation in the festival, because I figure the adjudicates are just as sick of the routine as we are. So we're going to sing for you What a Wonderful World from Good Morning Vietnam, and we'll be doing that at the end of the festival as well. Before the choir leaves, it's traditional now that, you know, we have instrumental and vocal music in the school, and we like to honor a graduating student who we feel has contributed greatly to the cause of vocal music, entertaining us and being very encouraging in the program. I'd like to ask Margaret Corcoran, who's been teaching our vocal course, to present the award. This year's winner, graduating student, vocal music, Geraldine Espejo. Another fast change and you'll get some Dixieland music in a minute. Thank you for being patient, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Dixieland Band. I'm Frank Whitman. Dixieland music was a form that originated during the roaring 1920s. It's one of the earliest forms of jazz music, thus allowing for improvisation. Music became fun. Each individual here, you'll notice there's just one of each instrument. And so it's very important that these people are not only talented, but able to independently think through the music. And I think that's the kind of group we have assembled here right now. If everything's ready, we're going to start with I Can't Give You Anything But Love, written in 1928. Actually, one song, tuning first.
Thank you. soloists in that number were Wayne Tan on vocals, Kim Beauchamp on clarinet, Laura Lapadula on trumpet, Francie Rotondo on tenor sax, Dave Michaelberger on trombone. The other members, equally if not more important, are Janet Seo on piano, Junipero Langtapan on bass, and Nelson Deveris, who's only in grade 9 and is often ridiculed for it, is on drums. The next number is not really a Dixie number, it's actually a rag, but done in a Dixie style. It's Maple Leaf Rag, written in 1899. That's a little before I was born. Actually, it's a little before my father was born, and he's old. It's a rag done in a Dixie style and features Janet Seo on piano. Which will come in between us, and I'll let that vocal group set up now.
It's something the three of us have arranged ourselves, a little a cappella number. It's an oldie but a goodie. It's been around for ages, but most recently it was the lullaby in the movie Three Men and a Baby. It's called Goodnight, Sweetheart.
Well, it's time. baby. I'm just getting deeper right. Well, I have to leave you, baby. Don't call me crazy because I'm so.
Jamela Spejo and Michael Wise, and they've been doing that for a little while now. They've mastered it. I'm going to steal Wayne Tan from that group for our last Dixieland number before the intermission. We have a little preparation to do here right now. Well, you might tell from your program, it's called The Sheik of Araby, written in 1921 by Ted Snyder. Well, we have more than one sheik. We've got three if you include Dave on trombone and Nelson on drums. And so plural, the sheiks of Araby will sing to probably someone in the audience of their choice. Are we ready?
Thank you.
is to the Sheiks, Javier V, Wayne Tan, Dave Michaelberger, and Nelson, who would have liked to join them if he could have, but he was on the drums. Soloists were Dave Michaelberger, who had an original solo, along with Francie Rotondo and Juniper Olajuwon. I believe this is intermission time. There are refreshments for you outside the back. The art students at Cardinal Wagey put a lot of hard work and creativity into those, and that's due in part to the direction of Michael Halliwell and Glory McConnell. I think they deserve a warm round of applause. You will have an opportunity to see that after the evening is over if you didn't during the intermission. And we're going to start the second half off with the senior concert band under the direction of Mr. Brian Tisdale. Thank you. That was Granville Island Overture by Jay O'Reilly. I believe we have Janet Seale coming out next. I'd just like to thank Janet for doing such a great job on the Maple Leaf Rag earlier. It's a difficult number, and with her talent, though, she did an excellent job on it. And she's going to do something else for you, one of her own compositions, and I'll let her introduce it for you when she's ready.
For our next presentation, we'll be performing Purpose in His Plan. We have our vocalist here, Natalie Rodriguez, and accompanying her we have our two flautists, Marianne Allen and Linda Pimentel.
I'd like to take a moment and just change the focus from students on the teachers. I'd ask Ms. Corcoran, Mrs. Tomchik, Mr. Whitman, and Mr. Tisdale to come on down front and center, and it's your turn to shine. Well, over here, please. This year, as you can see, our faculty has really grown. Our staff has even doubled. It can only reveal what kind of things we're doing here and how things are expanding. We need more people to handle everything. This year, Ms. Corcoran taught our vocal class, and she also brought her Irish folk group more than once over here to Leger. At one point, we had a fiddler in the class, and it's a unique experience because it's one thing to know what a fiddle is or a violin is, but it's another thing to actually see someone play it up close. So, on behalf of everyone who benefited from it, thank you. Mr. Whitman is presently teaching a grade 9 instrumental music class, and he's also the founder of our Dixieland band, and the kids really enjoy the music that they do, and they say it's hard, but once you get to know it, it's really good, it's fun. So, thank you for your effort all this year. Mrs. Tomchick, well, you've almost made it through your first year. I don't think you'll fully be broken in, though, until you've made it through our trip. So, we'll see what happens then. I hope we haven't been too hard on you, and I hope you've enjoyed your year as much as we have. I'd like to thank you for your time spent with the junior band and the stage band. I think that your efforts have really paid off. Mr. Tisdale, I've been doing this for, I think it's 4 years now, and it's getting a little hard to do something new and creative every time, you know, Mr. Tisdale's always here. So, I thought that this year, because I'm graduating, I'd speak on behalf of the graduating class. I'd like to express our gratitude for the past 4 years here at Leger. Obviously, the foremost intention was to form us as musicians and round us off well. But he's also managed to mold us as people. We've experienced a music camp where we worked with professional musicians, and I don't think I even have to mention England. I mean, that was an experience of a lifetime that few of us even dreamt of for future life, you know, when we finished our education, let alone when we were in high school. It was a real opportunity that we wouldn't have had it not been for Mr. Tisdale. Through all the trips, though, the focus was on music, and we always did well in the festivals that we participated in. These trips also helped us grow as we learned how to deal with a family of 80 members. I mean, there's a lot of give and take that has to be done when you go on these trips, and you have to learn how to handle them. You can be sure that when we look back on our high school years, that much of the memories that we have are going to be of the music and the bands and the trips that we've taken, be it rehearsals, band, choir, all the different things, they're all going to be in there. This year we're going to Quebec City and we'll have an opportunity to use the French we've been learning in classes and get another memory for future life. As a class, we're graduating, but I don't think you think that you're ever going to get rid of us. We'll be back. What more can I say? It's been a great year. Thanks to all of you from all of us.
Brian will say a few words later. I'd like to thank Melanie. I'll be paying her later. You might notice, while we're picking on Mr. Tisdale, you might notice we're both wearing navy blue jackets. I'd just like you to know that I thought of it first. Okay. I believe Phil Svensson is coming up next, and he will introduce his next member.
Our band's called Broken Wings, and I'd like to introduce the band. We got Peter on guitar. Turn around, Peter. And OB on bass. And Dan on drums. And my name's Phil Svensson, as you know. And the song we're going to do for you is by Crowded House, and it's called Better Be Home Soon. Somewhere deep it's pushing me aside. See it stretch on forever.
I believe it is time now for the Senior Music Participation Awards. And I'd like to call on Mr. Brian Tisdale. Did he just leave the room? Oh, here he is. Mr. Brian Tisdale to present the Senior Music Participation Awards.
Usually when we have these award ceremonies, I ask a student, unfortunately. I've been used to asking Melanie every year, and she's graduating. So I decided I'd better go down a few grades, and I've asked her sister, Natalie. Appreciate her helping us out here. These awards, senior participation awards, are for students who are graduating and leaving the school and have been involved in music, various music activities throughout their career here. First person we'd like to give the award to just arrived this year, but got involved in just about every activity that was possible for his particular area. Leger Participation Award for Chris Savage. She's our only bass clarinet player. We're going to have to train another one. She's graduating, Sonia Wilson. Our first alto player and a great vocalist as well, Geraldine Espejo. our section leader for the trombone section, and a person who loves to dance in those clubs in England, David Michaelberger. First clarinet player and our concert mistress this year, Natasha Cesare. I start choking up at this point. I remember them as little grade 10 kids. Now they're leaving school. Person who knows how to drum his way through your life, Brent Drozdowski. A young lady with a beautiful soprano voice, Lynn Backus. And this lady needs no introduction, Melanie Alexander, our first solo. Another percussionist, there are a lot of them this year, Marasco Lett. And our third graduating percussionist, Jeff Martin. Band isn't a band without a trustworthy tenor sax player, our lead tenor, Francie Rotondo. Young man who's played trumpet for 4 years, I'm not sure he's able, well, I should see. Is Tony here? Tony Armada? It was a trade-off. It was this or not go to Quebec. That's what the boss man said at his work. So I'd like to congratulate him anyways for going to Quebec with us. Tony Armada. A young lady who's with us for 4 years, but unfortunately night school forced her to give up the band about 2 months ago. Night school nasty. I don't know whether she was able to be with us tonight because of this night school situation. Rosalind Verano. Is she here, Rosalind? Well, we'll make sure she gets the award. Young lady who has decided that she will be the best music teacher in the world, so both of us here are going to be watching out for that. Laura Lapadula. I'm going to miss this young lady because she keeps a certain section civilized. Trombone sections really do need women to keep them civilized. Paulette McKeon. Ladies and gentlemen, these are graduating music students. Thank you. This is the second year in a row. I think it's in the music office, Ruth. We were sorting through them, and I think maybe it's on the desk. I would like to introduce our first flute player, graduated. And I'm sorry, Ruth. I'll make sure you get your award. Ruth Dias. I'll get it right next year. Okay, we'd like to go on now and play a piece of the challenge piece for the festival in Quebec, an Irish Rhapsody. Thank you. senior concert band would like to play for you. Selections from a musical that's on in Toronto. It's been on in London for 2 years in New York. I hear from some of the students and teachers who've gone to see it that it's a fantastic musical. Selections from Les Misérables. Thank you. soloist on flute, Ruth Diaz. Stand up, Ruth. Come on, stand up. And the finest you've ever played, Laura, Laura Lapadula on trumpet. Once again, parents, friends, teachers, students, Leje, we'd like to thank you for the support you've given us through the years, and especially this year as well. Before we finish, though, we have one type of award that still must be given, and that's the Leje Music Award. I'd ask our principal, Mr. Joe Moore, to come up and do the presenting, please. The Leje Music Award is given to a graduating student who has demonstrated through the years that they're very active participators, that they understand and demonstrate musical excellence, and what's important, very important to us as teachers at Leje, they demonstrate leadership, and in particular Christian leadership. It means the type of student that's very good. This year, the music staff talked, we listened to nominations from the students at the senior level. We decided this year that it was a tie. We have two winners of the Leje Music Award, Melanie Ann Alexander and David Michael Berger. Please come up.
As a principal, I am always amazed and delighted to be surrounded by a strong staff. I began teaching in 1962, and when you have been in the business that long, one of the things that you really come to realize is the importance of parents. And if there are any parents of these two people in the audience tonight, I'd like you to come on up and be on stage with your children. There's an old theory, good children just don't happen, they're produced, and you have to acknowledge the mom and dad as well. Thank you, folks.
We promise we'll take good care of them in Quebec City. They got back from England, so I think they'll be okay up in Quebec. Thank you very much for coming out tonight.